The White House has chastised the media for distorting the facts to discredit the administration's tough immigration policy. It's after a major news magazine published an unrelated but powerful photo on its cover to slam Trump. But as Caleb Maupin explains, similar cases are becoming more frequent on both sides of the debate.
They say that a picture is worth a thousand words. Powerful images hit you in the gut, and they pluck at our heartstrings. But they can also be deceiving. Take a look at this cover of Time magazine. The little girl in this photo has become symbolic of the Trump administration's policy of separating undocumented children from their parents. Here's the original photo, and here's how the photo has been used in mainstream media.
I could sit here all day and tell you about President Trump's new zero-tolerance immigration policy, or I could just show you a single picture, this one.
No one image has come to define the policy more than this one. It shows a two-year-old Honduran girl crying as her mother is pat down.
As it happens, the girl in the image was actually not separated from her mother, unlike lots of other children. Her father in Honduras has confirmed that.
You can imagine how I felt when I saw that photo of my daughter. It broke my heart. It's difficult as a father to see that, but I now know that they are not in danger. They are safer now than when they were making that journey to the border.
So cue the clarifications, retractions, and updates from outlets like the Washington Post that ran with the "this little girl was taken away from her parents" story.
The father of the little girl told the Washington Post that the child and mother were not separated. U.S. and Honduran officials have confirmed the father's account to other news organizations.
Actually, both sides of American politics are guilty of doing this. They find a very powerful image, and they run with it, no matter where it came from. Take the right-wing blog Drudge Report. They're generally supportive of Trump's immigration policies. They found this photo and said that it was immigrants crossing the U.S. border. Actually, this photo is from Syria. Take this photo of a child in a cage, posted by a journalist to raise awareness about the plight of migrant children, even though he admitted he didn't know where the photo came from.
Still trying to find a source for this photo. Saw it on a Facebook friend's timeline, but looking for confirmation. Has anyone seen it elsewhere?
Well, it's not hard to establish that the child was participating in a protest. It's a mock cage. Now, there's one photo that's circulating around that actually does show a child that is actually in a cage. Jon Favreau, an Obama speechwriter, tweeted it out with the words, "This is happening now." Well, actually, the photo's from 2014, and it was happening then with Obama presiding over it. Now, children were actually being separated from their parents, and the outrage was in response to a very real policy from the Trump administration. But it's important to take a deep breath, learn all the facts, and not let every sensational, heart-wrenching image be taken at face value. Caleb Maupin, RT, New York.
Picking up on that, legal and media analyst Lionel told us these latest cases go to show just how low the standards of journalism have fallen recently.
When you have organizations, news organizations, that don't merely obfuscate the facts or exaggerate or do anything to give the wrong impression or are biased, but when they lie, when they show pictures that are 5 years old, or pictures that aren't what they appear to be, or pictures of children who are not unaccompanied, that's called lying. That's a distortion. It's not, well, it's truly fake news.
Here's how the photo has been used in mainstream media.
I could sit here all day and tell you about President Trump's new zero-tolerance immigration policy, or I could just show you a single picture, this one.
No one image has come to define the policy more than this one. It shows a two-year-old Honduran girl crying as her mother is pat down.
As it happens, the girl in the image was actually not separated from her mother, unlike lots of other children. Her father in Honduras has confirmed that.
You can imagine how I felt when I saw...
The White House has chastised the media for distorting the facts to discredit the administration's tough immigration policy. It's after a major news magazine published an unrelated but powerful photo on its cover to slam Trump. But as Caleb Morpin explains, similar cases are becoming more frequent on both sides of the debate.
They say that a picture is worth a thousand words. Powerful images hit you in the gut, and they pluck at our heartstrings. But they can also be deceiving. Take a look at this cover of Time magazine. The little girl in this photo has become symbolic of the Trump administration's policy of separating undocumented children from their parents. Here's the original photo, and they run with it no matter where it came from. Take the right-wing blog Drudge Report. They're generally supportive of Trump's immigration policies. They found this photo and said that it was immigrants crossing the U.S. border. Actually, this photo is from Syria. Take this photo of a child in a cage, posted by a journalist to raise awareness about the plight of migrant children, even though he admitted he didn't know where the photo came from.
Still trying to find a source for this photo. Saw it on a Facebook friend's timeline, but looking for confirmation. Has anyone seen it elsewhere?
Well, it's not hard to establish that the child was participating in a protest.
That photo of my daughter, it broke my heart. It's difficult as a father to see that, but I now know that they are not in danger. They are safer now than when they were making that journey to the border.
So cue the clarifications, retractions, and updates from outlets like the Washington Post that ran with the "this little girl was taken away from her parents" story.
The father of the little girl told the Washington Post that the child and mother were not separated. U.S. and Honduran officials have confirmed the father's account to other news organizations.
Actually, both sides of American politics are guilty of doing this. They find a very powerful image. It's a mock cage. Now, there's one photo that's circulating around that actually does show a child that is actually in a cage. Jon Favreau, an Obama speechwriter, tweeted it out with the words, "This is happening now." Well, actually, the photo's from 2014, and it was happening then with Obama presiding over it. Now, children were actually being separated from their parents, and the outrage was in response to a very real policy from the Trump administration. But it's important to take a deep breath, learn all the facts, and not let every sensational, heart-wrenching image be taken at face value. Caleb Maupin, RT, New York.
Picking up on that, legal...